Google Drive or OneDrive? Which one should you use? I literally use both, so I'd probably have a pretty good idea of what the differences between the two are. So going right into the different plans here, we can see that from a Google Drive perspective, there is a new Google One system where essentially for personal use, you have the option to have a few different things. So the recommended plan that they have is 100 gigabytes for $2 a month. There is a standard plan of 200 for $299 a month. And then there's premium for $10 a month, which gives you 2 terabytes. I think this one is probably the only option that I would ever recommend for a cloud storage service. I mean, it's like, you gotta go between this or this. This one's just, sure, it's like a better value than the 100, but it's a little bit useless to have like another 100. You really need like terabytes of storage if we're talking about cloud storage nowadays with the size of files. I don't really understand why it's this pricing whatsoever. This price allows you to share with up to 5 other people. You get some extra member benefits and 10% back in the Google Store. So I think going with this plan is probably the best option. $10 a month for storage is not a crazy amount. If you need small storage, go with this one. I don't really see the point of having 200 gigabytes. It's like either you need a lot or you need a little. From a standpoint of what you can use this on your desktop, you can use it on your Mac, you can use it on your phone. And then for the cloud storage regarding Microsoft, you get a few different options here. There's Microsoft 365 Personal, which gives you 1 terabyte for $69.99 a year, which is about $583 a month, or you can buy it for $699 a month if you want to go from a monthly perspective. And you also get Outlook, Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, which is nice. Now, obviously, Google just has Google Sheets, Google Slides, all those different things integrated for free in their suite. Obviously, the difference pricing here is interesting. So you can have $100 a year, which is a little bit cheaper than $9.99 a month as an option, as is usually the case with yearly pricing. Either you can pay $8.3 a month for 2 terabytes or $5.83 a month for 1 terabyte. Now, this might be the best value one by far, unless you're in a family, which this kind of is a huge thing for me. If you're in a family, you have a bunch of kids that need the storage for whatever reason, it does not hurt to go with the Microsoft 365 plan because you also get Office apps included. If you're a parent who's looking to get kids stuff for school regarding storage and different workplace stuff like Office apps, I would kind of recommend this plan. But from a personal standpoint, this is going to give you the best bang for your buck. But I'm going to show you the desktop capabilities of both right here. So if we look in here, we have a shared drive that I have with my buddy Chance, and we have my OneDrive personal account. So the OneDrive personal account is cool. You can do a lot of different basic sharing things, like right clicking and sharing is really easy on here. This is very similar to a lot of different things that you'll notice within the Microsoft Teams ecosystem and whatnot. You can do a little bit of a sharing situation. So I just press this and then apply, and then I can copy it to share links with anybody. Or if I do the exact same thing with this one right here, what I can do is type in the email and send different things to different people's emails, which is also a very simple sharing experience. But what's nice about OneDrive is that you can free up storage on your computer really quick by just pressing free up space. And you could also do the opposite, which is always keep on device, which would make it then be locally stored and be stored on the cloud. There's not a whole lot of different things I want to dive into with OneDrive, except for go to the bottom right here. There's this cloud, which basically allows you to open up the settings here, and it's my OneDrive personal. You can view it online really quickly by going there and interact with all of your different files here. And now the app is actually really solid on the phone. I will say that I think it has a pretty great experience. It might actually be better than the Google Drive experience. If you're looking for a better mobile experience, the OneDrive one actually is a little bit better. And then you can look within your recycle bin, open folders, and then go to the settings really easily here and change what folders you're storing things on your account. It shows you what your storage use is on your account as well. And then you're also able to pause syncs for a short period of time or quit OneDrive as well. Now, from a Google Drive standpoint, you have a very similar situation where there's the setup on the web, which a lot of people are probably familiar with, as everyone's pretty much used Google Drive that I know of. And for me, I believe that the situation I got going on with my Google Drive is really nice on the PC, because nobody really realizes that you can download Google Drive for desktop. I've made a video on that if you want to go check that out, but the way that this works is very similar. So it showcases what's recently synced. In the settings here, you can pause syncing. You can go and show what errors have happened earlier. You can go to preferences on this and pick folders to safely back up your files and choose whether you want things to mirror files. So store all my drive files in the cloud and on your computer, or stream files, which is store all my drive files in the cloud only and access them from a virtual drive on your computer. Choose specific files and folders to make available offline. This is really good for storage on your computer, and I think it's a little bit better than the OneDrive situation going on. But if I open it up here, you can see that I have a really nice setup, very similar to what I had in OneDrive. And just to show you how you can share files and whatnot, let's say I go to my Todoist course, right click, and share with Google Drive, very similar to sharing with OneDrive. And then since I'm in a business, I can just do something really quickly, which would just change it to share with anyone with link, copy to, and then paste that to somebody. Or I can share it again by doing this and then adding people via email. Now, if you want to access this offline, you can change this to available offline, but this is actually accessing it online only. So I'm opening this through a virtual drive on my computer, which I think is really convenient. I mean, this opens up really quick, so it's not like I'm having any problems there. If you have solid internet, this is gonna work fine. You have the ability to manage versions as well. There's no older versions of that, but if there was, it would show it. And you can just copy link to keyboard really quickly. I paste this in here. I go right to that file since I am signed into that account. And then something really cool that I enjoy is the fact that if we go to some of these admin things, let's go to like a business budget one here, I can open up a file that is a Google Sheet and it'll open up right here, which I enjoy. And I just want to give a quick verdict on this. As can be seen, I've used Google Drive, I've used OneDrive, and I think that Google Drive is a little bit better. Now the pricing for families, if you're a family, I would recommend going with OneDrive for that reason. But if you're using it for personal use, the Google Drive situation works great on Mac, and it works great on PC, and it works great on phones. And it's going to be easier to share things and interact with people if you're sharing things like Google Sheets or Google Docs rather than Microsoft documents, because that is a little bit less universal for people who are on Mac and whatnot. Getting that storage and interacting with it with that virtual drive has been really great for my storage, and I really enjoy it. But if you want to enjoy improving your productivity even more, I would check out this video right here.